Good morning, MIS students. Today we are going to learn about a new and exciting program that's called Young Champions. And to help us learn about this new program, please welcome my friend, Mr. Tornquist.
Thank you, Mr. Baldwin. Hello, students. I am very happy to be working with Manchester Intermediate School and to have this opportunity to talk to you about Young Champions. Before we get into that, however, I'd like to get to know all of you a little bit better. I'd like to invite each of you to play a game with me called That's Me. I'm going to read a sentence. If the sentence describes you, I just want you to raise your hand and yell, "That's me," and put your hand back down again. All right. So, Mr. Baldwin, if I read a sentence that describes you, what will you say?
That's me.
Perfect. All right. Here we go. I am into sports. I stink at sports. Me too. I am the oldest child. I am the youngest child. I am the favorite child. Good for you. I can play a musical instrument. I love to sing. When I sing, people run. I'm sorry to hear that. I love video games. I would rather play video games than take a shower. Okay, that's not good. I have lived in Indiana my entire life. I have visited more than three other states. I have traveled to Walmart. Yeah, nobody cares. I have a dog. I have a cat. I have a farm animal. I have a brother who smells like a farm animal. I send at least 10 text messages every day. I send at least 50 text messages every day. I have sent at least one text message since this old dude started talking to us. I like to read. I like to shop. I like to eat ice cream and watch Netflix. My people. And finally, I want Manchester Intermediate to be a unified champion school.
That is definitely me.
Great job. I'll tell you why I love that game. I love that game because it does a beautiful job of illustrating that while we all have things that make us unique as individuals, there are other qualities which we all share in common. For instance, we all like to laugh, and we all like to feel like we are part of a larger group. That's what Young Champions is all about. Young Champions wants to make sure that every student at Manchester Intermediate School feels included. Now, to earn a Unified Champion School banner, a school must do four things. We call these pillars. Mr. Baldwin, can you tell us what is the first pillar?
Pillar number one is inclusive student leadership.
That's right, inclusive student leadership. Why inclusive student leadership? Well, when you do something for someone, that's really nice. But when you do something with someone, it empowers that student, just like it did for the young people in this video.
It was senior year and the whole school was cheering for her. And just seeing the smile on her face, people were crying and people were cheering. Seeing how the whole school came together just for her was the most amazing thing ever. Special Olympics is acceptance.
Joy.
Respect.
It made me feel better about myself, being around thousands of people just cheering me on, and it was a fun experience, trust me.
Special Olympics is about life and being accepted by everybody.
Special Olympics is health.
Education.
Sports.
It's made me who I am today. It's made me more outgoing. It's made me just more of a genuine person.
When I got involved with Special Olympics, it kind of like brought me out of my shell.
And it's not about disabilities, but it's about celebrating their abilities.
When I was in fourth grade, my teacher told me she would never answer my questions because I had too many, and I was too dumb to understand the answers anyways. After joining Special Olympics, I know that's not the case. I am just as smart as anyone else.
It has helped me a lot to be fearless, you know, in the real world.
Special Olympics is community.
Special Olympics is friendship.
My friends I've made through Special Olympics are the best people I've ever met in my life.
It had gave me a chance to meet new people from different states.
And you just gain an entire family of new friends.
Special Olympics is dignity.
Justice.
Empowerment.
I truly realize that what I'm doing is for a great cause.
I could spend all my time just working with Special Olympics, and I would love every second of it.
It makes you feel like a wonderful person, and your life changes forever.
I've made a difference. Now it's your turn to make a difference.
We are champions together.
Making a difference every day.
All right, Mr. Baldwin, can you please tell us what is pillar number two?
Pillar number two is whole school engagement.
Whole school engagement. That means we want every student and every staff member here at Manchester Intermediate School to join the inclusion revolution. And when a school is truly unified, it often looks like this.
Disability. It's about all kinds of moments when you can choose to include on the bus, in the cab, in the hall, in classrooms. There will be moments when you look across the room and you'll see someone isolated, someone left out, someone lonely, someone challenged, someone made fun of, someone humiliated, someone not included. And the question you will face is, will you choose to include that person or will you move on?
Thank you, Mr. Shriver. And now I choose to include each one of you in another game. The name of this game is Would You Rather? And like inclusion, this game is all about choices. I'm going to give you two options. If you prefer option number one, you hold up one finger. If you prefer option number two, hold up two fingers. All right, here we go. Would you rather one, eat a spider, or two, find a snake under your pillow? Would you rather one, eat a spider, or two, find a snake under your pillow? Would it help if I told you you could put ketchup on the spider? All right, tonight, if I find a snake under my pillow, you're going to know about it because you're going to hear me scream all the way from my house. Here's another one. Would you rather, one, sit next to someone who talks too loudly, hey there, howdy, how you doing? Or two, sit next to someone who is constantly staring at you? All right, one is obnoxious and two is just plain creepy. Here's another one. Would you rather, one, have an elephant-sized cat, or two, have a cat-sized elephant? Would you rather one, have an elephant-sized cat, or two, have a cat-sized elephant? I asked this question to one of my daughters, and she said, Dad, having an elephant-sized cat would be the most frightening thing ever. Meow. Meow. All right. Would you rather, one, yell Yahoo every time someone says hi to you, or two, do the dab every time someone says hi to you? Would you rather, one, yell Yahoo every time someone says hi to you, or two, do the dab every time someone says hi to you? All right, I want to try something here. On the count of three, I'm going to say hi to you, and I want to see or hear how you prefer to respond, all right? Here we go. One, two, three. Oh, hi. Very good. Okay, last one. Would you rather, one, have hiccups for an entire day, or two, wink at every person you see for an entire day? Would you rather, one, have hiccups for an entire day, or two, wink at every person you see for an entire day? All right, I want to try a little experiment here. I want you to look at the person sitting nearest you and just give them a little wink. Now, why did I ask you to do that? Well, I believe it's almost impossible not to smile when someone's winking at you. Okay, Mr. Baldwin has been waiting in his office very patiently to tell us about pillar number three. Mr. Baldwin, what is pillar number three?
Pillar number three is unified sports.
Unified sports. That's when you take students with disabilities, students without disabilities, and you put them together on the same team. And when you do that, something magical happens. It just becomes one big group of students competing and having so much fun, just like the students in this video.
Today was a great day. We participated with the Special Olympians and participated in sports, basketball, dancing, trivia, soccer, relays, and it's just really inspiring to see that regardless of people and their disabilities, they're still willing to step out of their comfort zones and encourage each other and create an atmosphere of positivity.
This experience has been amazing. The inclusiveness, and it's incredible. My uncle is actually in Special Olympics, and I know how much it's affected his life, and he loves it. And I love seeing the way he talks about his face lights up, all of his friends going out with them, you know, always something to lean on, and it's incredible. I love it.
It's a very fun evening. I'm glad to be here, mostly because I've done it last year, and I just can't say enough. It's just too fun for words.
I love NFHS, thank you.
Thank you. Doesn't that look fun? Okay. According to my count, we've come to our fourth and final pillar. Mr. Baldwin, what is pillar number four?
Pillar number four is fundraising.
Fundraising. The goal is to raise at least $250 to help Special Olympics Indiana promote unified sports all over our great state. You know, when I think about all of the wonderful things that schools are doing through Young Champions, it makes me happy. And when I'm happy, you know what I like to do? I like to dance, which brings us to our final activity. I call this an inclusive mini dance marathon. And since it's inclusive, that means you all are invited to participate. I have put together one 3-minute mix, which features 15 of my all-time favorite dance songs. We're about to do 15 songs in 3 minutes. I'm going to give you a little clue, then the music will begin. And I want you to go with whatever dance moves pop into your mind. Now, save your best moves till the end, because on the last song, you get to really show off your best stuff. All right? So get up, find yourself a little space there on the floor. And since I'm the DJ for this song and this little dance, I got to put on my special DJ headphones. And we're going to get started with a little Beyoncé. Take it away. Gangnam Style.
Open Gangnam Style. Gangnam Style. Open Gangnam Style.
Baby Shark.
Baby Shark. Baby Shark. Baby Shark. Baby Shark.
Hammer Time.
Can't touch this. Can't touch this. Touch this.
Stop. Pokey Pokey.
You put your right hand in, you put your right hand out. You put your right hand in and you shake it all about. You do the Hokey Pokey and you turn yourself around. That's what it's all about.
Nay, nay.
Now watch me whip.
Hey.
Now watch me nay, nay.
Okay.
Now watch me whip.
Whip.
Watch me nay, nay.
Can you do?
Disco. Now, for a complete change of pace, we take you to the beautiful world of ballet dancers. Cupid Shuffle.
To the right, to the right, to the right, to the right, to the left, to the left, to the left, to the left.
Chicken Dance.
Oh!
YMCA.
It's fun to stay at the
YMCA.
It's fun to stay at the
YMCA.
Hillbilly. Last one, your
I'm
best move. Go on. That was awesome. Give yourself a round of applause. I would like to finish my time up with you today by telling you a story about a starfish. But it's not a day that looks like this. It's a day that looks like this. Starfish for as far as the eye can see. Well, on this day, an old guy kind of like me was walking along a beach, and he sees off in the distance a young person, much like yourself, and the young person is doing something that really confuses the old guy. He sees the young person bend down, pick something up, throw it in the water. Bend down, pick something up, throw it in the water over and over again. Well, finally, the curiosity gets the best of the old man, and he approaches the young person and says, "Excuse me, I don't mean to bother you, but I have a question. What are you doing?" And the young person said, "Well, sir, there was a horrible storm that came in last night and washed all these starfish up on the beach. And I don't know if you realize this or not, but if these starfish don't get back in the water, they're going to die. So I'm out here just trying to make a difference." Well, the old guy laughed. "You got to be kidding me. Look at this beach. There's miles of beach. There are thousands of starfish. Kid, you will never make a difference." Well, the young person bent back down, picked up a starfish, and held it up for the man to see. And the student said, "Sir, I'm going to make a difference to this one," and threw it back in the water. When you choose to include another student into your circle of friends, you have changed that student's day, you have changed their school year, and you have changed their life. Manchester Intermediate School, welcome to Young Champions. You are now officially leaders in the inclusion revolution. And now to wrap up our program, would you please welcome back the man of the hour, the tower of power, too sweet to be sour, your principal, Mr. Baldwin. Mr. Baldwin, take it away.
MIS students, one of the things that I love most about our school is our commitment to each other, to being a family, and being a community. The Unified Champions plays right into our core values that we have here at Manchester Intermediate School. Togetherness is something that we talk about frequently here amongst our school with our teachers, our students, and our outer community. And adding this Unified Champions banner will just accentuate all the great things that we're already doing. I'm proud of you for how hard you work on a daily basis. I'm proud of you for your commitment to do what's right. And I'm proud of you for your commitment to try to help one another. And I'm proud of us for our pursuit of becoming Unified Champions. We can do it.